This weekend in downtown Phoenix, there's an event billed as the state's first ever Latin Indie Music Festival. It was organized by Elisa Bustamante, aka the Funky Latina, a Phoenix-based music blogger and event producer. And as with so many things these days, the idea for the festival was born on social media.
I'm Elisa Bustamante, aka the Funky Latina from Phoenix, and I founded Arizona's first Latin Indie Music Festival. The Funky Latina actually started through my music blogging, but to be honest, I've always been the Funky Latina since I was born. I've always been Latina and I've always been funky. It's not something I turn off and on, but the Funky Latina is something that I turn up. Selena Quintanilla definitely has inspired me.
Tonight we'll be showcasing the film Selena, and what I want to know is, what does Selena mean to you and how does she represent your culture?
Being Mexican American and not being fluent in Spanish but being able to sing in Spanish is something I absolutely identify with, because I'm not fluent in Spanish. I speak Spanglish. I was interviewing a band from Austin, Texas, Brother Sport, and they were talking about how it's really hard to be on the top of a bill in a festival.
Sometimes it just feels like I have to do certain things and behave this way, look this way, feel this way.
These spaces weren't made for us, so we have to make our own lanes, and we have to do what we have to do to not just sell music, but to be viable.
And so I got inspired from that interview to, instead of waiting for someone to make a festival for us, let's build our own. Let's have our own festival where we are on the bill from top to bottom, and it's something that we create. One of the ways I was able to secure funding was by using my own money. So I put my own money into this. Beyonce says, if you're gonna invest in somebody, invest in yourself. Girls, we run this mother. Yeah. So during this time, COVID was at an all-time high. We were still at home. And also this was, you know, in the middle of the Black Lives Matter protests.
So we're not the only ones that is tired of people like myself, people that looks like me, getting murdered out in the streets.
It was tough. It was a hard time, like when I think about it now. It was very hard to find inspiration. That's what pushed me even more towards music, because that was the only place that I found inspiration, comfort, safety, and I felt like it was the only language I could speak.
Okay. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. I just got my first sponsorship. Shout out to Fair Trade Cafe, Latina owned. Stephanie, never gonna forget this. Thank you.
As soon as I got the idea for the music festival, I started looking for artists. I would pick an artist and I would think about their music, and I would think about who would listen to this. And there's like the Brown Boys. I was like, okay, my brother would love this music. Or Crisol, who was the headline of the festival. I was like, this music reminds me of like my mom and her sisters and dancing. And so everybody on the lineup kind of had a special memory for me. And each act on the lineup was a different kind of genre, so that anybody that came to the music festival would find something that they liked.
Good morning, it's Saturday. We are 34 days away from the event. And this morning I'm going to Cordoba Cafe to drop off some flyers. They're having like a local market.
Thank you to the Funky Latina. Vibes, love, and funk, baby. She's got some pretty dope performers.
I don't know how I still have friends after this event, because I was literally texting, emailing, but I was even on Facebook Messenger, DMing people and telling them about my event. This is the marketing campaign. Let's see if it works. 3 weeks from the event, I got a phone call from the venue, and they were a little concerned because ticket sales were really low. And they're like, hey, we need to talk about this. What do you want to do? Do you want to make this a free event? Do you want to lower ticket prices? Do you want to cancel the event? And so I was like so upset. I called my brother, I called my mom, and I don't know what it was, but I just like, I had this plan and I wanted to see it through so bad. And so the next day I called the venue back and I said, I don't want to change anything. I want to keep selling tickets. I want to try to sell this event out. After that day, I was maybe like 3 weeks out, and Literally every single day, I was calling people, texting people, asking for help. I had never hustled so hard in my life.
I'm so excited to share that Marca Marketing Consulting is an event sponsor.
I was interviewed by Prensa Arizona, which is a live interview in Spanish. I was like, wait, what?
Eres una blogger de música.
Almost turned it down because I was so scared, but I was like, you know what? I gotta sell these tickets. So I'm gonna go on this show, I'm gonna do my best, and I'm just gonna try to speak Spanish. I don't think I ever stopped smiling that whole time because I was just so nervous and sweaty. Definitely working on my Spanish ever since that interview. But Saturday, it's the day of the event. Doors are open, people are coming in, and it was wild because you think about this moment and you're like, I hope it works out, and it did. It worked out.
All right, so now the time has come. Let's get the show started.
I was meeting people for the first time and they're like, are you the Funky Latina? And I'm like, yes. And so it was really cool to see people come inside, take pictures with them, and see them enjoy the music. Once the second act got up there, the venue was full. And I didn't have a count of how many tickets had been sold yet, but just seeing the venue, I had a really good feeling that, you know, I hit my goal. And I did, which is incredible for a first event. This young woman who attended my event, she sent me a message saying, thank you so much for tonight. She had never been in such a safe space before. Specifically for Latinos, I hope you keep doing this because I've never experienced anything like that. And so I was like, we're looking for community. So many people are looking for community, and that's what I provide as the Funky Latina. This is a place for music lovers. That's what inspires me to keep doing this. I can't wait to see all of you next year. Save the date.